Nokia's EOS is now being teased as the Lumia 909. Jay-Z's Magna Carta Holy Grail new album is now live for select Galaxy customers, and it seems that Samsung's plans for Tizen are slowing down. I'm Jaime Rivera, and if you see three of me, don't worry, it's completely normal after 10 beers. This is Pocket Now Daily. Let's start today off with the expected news as Jay-Z's Magna Carta Holy Grail new album is now available for select Galaxy customers in the United States. The reason why I say select is because it's only available for the Galaxy S4, Galaxy S3, Galaxy Note 2, among other flagships, not really the mid-tiered phones. But anyways, for those of you that have been able to listen to the album already, leave us a comment down below. Is it really good? And speaking of Samsung, we know that the company is working on another platform called Tizen because, yes, they already have Bada, I think, along with Android, etc., etc. But it seems that not everything is going well on that project. I mean, they were supposed to launch it this summer. Now they're saying that it's going to happen in the next couple of months. And as it turns out, well, we've been waiting for it for the whole year. It was actually announced a long time ago. And then we've got experts saying that apparently the project is already dead. They're just postponing it because, well, we don't know why, but apparently it's not gonna happen. It's just not gonna happen. Could it be that Samsung has really found heaven in Android? Hopefully that's the case. And yes, we've got more Samsung news. We've got more leaked specifications of the Galaxy Note 3 that's gonna be launched at IFA most likely. And as it turns out, aside from the full details that are in the links down below, we are getting 3 GB of RAM on this device. You know, we are expecting the Exynos Quad Octa processor, I hate that name, but among other things, it's interesting to see that Samsung is pushing the bar when it comes to memory, and none of us are gonna complain. Let's see how this device rolls when it comes, and let's see what screen size they end up choosing. Moving over to Nokia, the company keeps advertising their current devices as they're now posting photos of all the internals that you can find in the new camera of the Nokia Lumia 925. And yes, we have reviewed it, and it does take some very, very good photos, especially in low light, like the Lumia 920, only a little better. If you want to see the full specifications and the full imagery, well, links down below for the full description. It's just interesting that they're not showing us photos of the new technology that's coming in the EOS, and we are getting the Lumia 925, which we already knew about. And finally, for the interesting news of the day, we've got some more press renders of the Nokia EOS smartphone, which was apparently going to be called the Nokia Lumia 1020, but then things changed according to the tipster, and now it's going to be called the Lumia 909, which makes a lot of sense since the previous PureView phone was the 808. Well, we're expecting this device to be launched or at least announced on July 11th, so stay tuned for our coverage of that event. But anyways, that leads me to the question of the day. Is the Nokia Lumia 909 your next smartphone? Is this really something you're looking forward to? In my particular case, I'll be honest with you, if the price is right, I am getting it. But leave us a comment down below, what are you expecting for this phone? And of course, as always, for an earlier scoop of everything that's happening in the smartphone and tablet world, make sure you follow us on PocketNow.com and subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. You can also follow me on Twitter at Jaime_Rivera. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I am Jaime Rivera. Thank you very much for watching and happy 4th of July to all of you. See you tomorrow.